You are listening to the audio production of The Power of a Praying Woman by Stormie Omartian, published by Harvest House Publishers. This book is read by the author. That's me. This book is dedicated to my sisters in Christ all over the world who long to deepen their walk with the Lord, move into everything God has for them, and become all He made them to be. Let the beauty of the Lord, our God, be upon us, and establish the work of our hands for us. Psalm 90, 17. The Power. It doesn't matter what age you are, what your marital status is, what the condition of your body and soul, or how long you have or have not been a believer. If you are a woman, this book is for you. I've been a devoted follower of the Lord for more than 50 years, and I have not fallen away from Him in all that time. Yet I need this book too. In fact, I wrote it for myself as much as I wrote it for you. That's because I'm like you. Many days I find life difficult rather than easy, complex rather than simple, potentially dangerous rather than safe, and exhausting rather than exhilarating. Often it's more like a strong, hot, dry wind than it is a soft, cool, refreshing breeze. But I have come to know that God can smooth my path, calm the storms, keep me and all I care about safe, and even make my way simple when I ask Him to carry the complexities of life for me. But these things don't just happen. Not without prayer. In the midst of our busy lives, too often we don't pray enough, or we only pray about the most pressing issues and neglect to take the time to really get close to God, to know Him better, and to share with Him the deepest longings of our heart. In our pray-and-run existence, we shut off the very avenue by which He brings blessings into our lives, and we risk waking up one day with that empty, insecure feeling in the pit of our stomach, frightening us with the thought that our foundation may be turning into sand, and our protective armor may be becoming as fragile as an eggshell. This is what happened to me. A number of years ago, I had become so busy with working, taking care of teenagers, trying to be a good wife, running a home, writing books, and traveling to promote them, being at all church meetings, helping people who needed it, and trying to make everyone happy, that I neglected the most important thing, my intimate walk with God. It's not that I stopped walking with Him. To the contrary, I couldn't make it through a day without Him. It's not that I stopped praying. Actually, I was praying more than ever about everyone else on the planet, but I didn't pray about my own walk with Him. It's not that I didn't read His Word. I read for hours as I did research in the Scriptures for different projects I was working on and the Bible study classes I was taking, but I didn't give God time to speak to me personally through it. I was busy doing good and neglected to do what was best. I became Martha instead of Mary without even realizing it. See Luke 10:38-42. I didn't take enough time for God and me alone, and as a result, I became so depleted I couldn't go on. I felt like that eggshell, as if I could be crushed with very little outside pressure. I knew I needed more of God in my life, and nothing on earth was more important than that. There wasn't anything else that could satisfy the hunger I felt inside except more of His presence. And I came to realize how important it was for me to guard and protect my personal relationship with God in prayer. The way to avoid the kind of thing I experienced is to pray about every aspect of our life in such a manner that it will keep us spiritually anchored and reminded of what God's promises are to us. It will keep us focused on who God is and who He made us to be. It will help us live God's way and not our own. It will lift our eyes from the temporal to the eternal and show us what is really important. It will give us the ability to distinguish the truth from a lie. It will strengthen our faith and encourage us to believe for the impossible. It will enable us to become the women of God we long to be and believe we can be. Who among us doesn't need that? In my previous books on prayer, I have shared the ways husbands and wives can pray for one another, parents can pray for their young as well as their adult children, and children of all ages can pray for their own lives. In this book, I want to share how you can pray for you. I want to help you draw close to your Heavenly Father, to feel His arms around you, to maintain a right heart before Him, to live in the confidence of knowing you are in the center of His will, to discover more fully who He made you to be, to find wholeness and completeness in Him, and to move into all He has for you. In other words, I want to show you how to effectively cover your life in prayer so that you can have more of God in your life. Why is it so hard to pray for myself? Do you find it easier to pray for other people than it is to pray for yourself? I know I do. I can pray for my husband, my children, other family members, acquaintances, friends, and people I've never even met, whom I hear about in the news, far easier than I can pray for my own needs. For one thing, their needs are easy for me to identify. Mine are numerous, sometimes complicated, often difficult to determine, and certainly not easy to label. We women know what we think we need most of the time. We are able to recognize the obvious, but we are often too emotionally involved in the people around us and the day-to-day existence of our lives to be able to figure out how we should be praying for ourselves beyond the immediate and urgent. Sometimes we can be so overwhelmed by our circumstances that our prayer is simply a basic cry for help. Do you ever have times when your life seems out of control? Do you ever feel pressured, as if your days are so busy that you fear you're missing out on a certain quality of life because of it? Do you worry that you are neglecting one or more areas of your life because you are trying to fill numerous roles and meet many expectations? I've experienced that too. Have you ever felt as if your life is stuck in one place and you're going nowhere? Or worse yet, you're going backwards? Have you ever had times when you've lost your vision for the future? Or have you never really had one to begin with? Have you wondered whether you can actually move into the full purpose and destiny God has for you? Have you experienced feelings of emptiness, frustration, and unfulfillment? I too have felt all those things. Do you hunger for a greater sense of the Lord's presence in your life? Do you desire to know God in a deeper way? Do you want to serve Him better and more completely, but don't feel you have the time, energy, or opportunity to do so? Do you need to spend more time with Him in prayer? Do you want your prayers to be accompanied by greater faith so that you can see greater answers to them? Do you need a more complete knowledge and understanding of God's Word? Do you ever just long to throw your arms wide open and embrace Jesus, white robes and all, and feel His embrace of you? So do I. The good news is that this is the way God wants you to feel. God wants you to long for His presence. He wants you to find your fulfillment in Him and nothing else. He wants you to walk closely with Him. He wants you to increase in faith and knowledge of His Word. He wants you to put all your hopes and dreams in His hands and look to Him to meet all of your needs. When you do, He will open the storehouse of blessing upon your life. That's because these things are His will for you. But none of this happens without prayer. Where do I go to get my needs met? Every woman has needs, but many of us are guilty of looking to other people to meet them, especially the men in our lives. Too often we expect them to meet the needs that only God can fill, and then we are disappointed when they can't. We expect too much from them when our expectations should be in God. My friend Lisa Bevere expressed it best when she said that for centuries women have, quote, wrestled and waged war with the sons of Adam in an attempt.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.